All right, so this is freestyle challenge number 5. We're starting to really get through them now. This one, you know, humorous, but let's try and make something of it. Toto, Africa. You know, so I'm going to put a little interesting twist to it. Remember, this is all just for fun. You know, we're just having fun out here. Let's do this. Open up your mind's eye, and you can realize that we can fly up into the skies. We're living on this island, my whole tribe is living off the land. We have nothing to demand, we have nothing to understand, we just living off the earth. We know we achieve our worth, we just got a small places for us to chill at the end of the night, to set things right. We have an old man and he likes to write. He's got to write down what's going on around. People wonder how or why is this happening? What is the purpose of what you're writing? He said, I just need to do it. I need to get these words out. 'Cause that's what I'm about. If we design the route that we took in the past, we can remake it and make it last. And so the king asks, can you write something down for me? I have a small piece of poetry. It's been getting to me, and it seeps into my mind at night. But I don't know how to write. So the old man is like, yeah, I can do that for you. No problem. Whatever your problems are, I can solve them. If it involves a pen and pad. So next thing you know, everyone wishes they had the pen and pad. Everyone wishes that they had it like that old man, like dad. How the hell are you gonna write everything down when no one can tell what you're writing down? He had to create his own language. Every single symbol was his favorite. Every single day is a new inspiration to change it and recreate it. And that's how we created language. And so now there's other cultures, they want us some too. They say, can you come and make something for you? So something to describe all these things that we're living in. Describe this earth and this infinite materialism that people live in. We can describe different animals, different types of weather. You can describe things to make them better. You can describe things to make life better. You can even write it in a letter. And you can send it. You can imagine what you can send to someone. The imagination and possibilities is endless. And people said, yeah, that language, we gotta get it. So people come from all around. They heard about what this guy was writing down. And he didn't make it with sounds, but he tried to correlate that with different symbols and different patterns. And then they used math, and they got like, we gotta have it. We gotta make predictions and record everything that we're doing. Imagine if we knew what we were doing, and we can calculate exactly how many days it takes for the sunrise. And just imagine what's going on in these guys' heads. Back in the day when people said, we gotta write things down so we don't forget. Let's write that down. We gotta find language, find a way to describe these things that we came to. Try to find a way for us to make it in the future. A solution that we can send to you through different letters and solutions. It's congruent to the same symbolism that you saw when you witnessed it in the first conditions, sir. First edition just came out. The dictionary is what we're about. We just gotta let it out. Let people know how it's going down in this small little town. You gotta write it down. You just gotta write it down. As soon as you get it to your head, you gotta write it down. 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 As soon as you get your head, you gotta write it down. You gotta write it down. You gotta write it down. And if it's good, you gotta send it all around. Imagine making the first language. Imagine if you could describe everything and make it, recreate it, restate it for people to say for ages. Just have patience. We can just keep making it, saying it, stating it, retracing it, making it. Every single second you can write it down. Imagine now all the things that you could write down. What would you write? What would you write? Now we have more pens than we need a knife. You have more pens than you could use in your whole life. Imagine if you write every single thing down right. Imagine if you wrote it down the first time. And the next time you read it just to remind yourself what you were thinking. And if, imagine if you were still in the same place. You can recreate and retrace all the thoughts and memories that you had that one day. You can resave and save and send it today. Some person might need to hear the words that you gave. You can be saved by what you write down. So make sure you write it down, make sure you write it down, make sure you write it down. Every time that it comes around in your thoughts, in your head, write it down. Seriously, language is an amazing thing. You know, we can just describe things in infinite ways, write things down, send it in a letter, and make your descriptions better. Come on. I mean, it's beautiful. It's a beautiful concept. It kind of, I'm really glad that that went that way. You know, I just imagine, what were people doing chilling on an island? Maybe they wrote something down. And then it spread. And now we all are writing things down. It's kind of beautiful how that happens, you know, when you have the ability to send things to people who aren't there. You know, I'm experiencing that right now. You know, this is to everybody. Everyone who's watching, everyone who's listening. I'm sending this to you through language. And, you know, it's all possible because of words, because people work together to describe different things, to make different things. You know, it's all possible because of the things that other people have created. So let's just keep creating, keep making. The things you made today, while it may seem silly, it's like, why is that guy writing down? Why is that guy writing that down? What is the purpose? Right? It seems silly sometimes, but you never know what could come from it. You know, it could be something amazing that could change the world just because you thought it made something, because not even like you thought it was convenient. You just thought it was fun. You just enjoyed doing it. And yet you could unintentionally create something beautiful. Anything that you're doing, like, it's worth doing. Try things new. Try new things. Create things. Work to communicate. You know, language is beautiful. And I am appreciative of languages. You know, it's a useful tool. So, I appreciate you guys listening to that language that I said just now. Of the impromptu Toto Africa. About the people on an island who created language. Awesome. Thanks for listening. That was freestyle number 5.